Neil, how tough a test was that for the boys?
Yeah, it was tough, you know, considering the majority of them have only had 45 minutes of football. It was a real step up in quality, a real step up in tempo of the game, and I'm really pleased that we've come through it unscathed. Obviously, the sending off is a sore one, and we'll have to wait and see the outcome of that. But yeah, I mean, we had good chances to win the game, and we ran out of steam a bit towards the end, but that's totally understandable.
Are you concerned that there may be a chance that Jozo might not be available for competitive football after that red?
Yeah, I don't know what the rules are. I mean, it may have to come down to the referee's report, and if that's sent to the SFA, so we'll have to see what the priorities or the outcome as that's going to be. It's the first thing I asked the staff, you know, when it happened. Will he be eligible for enough for next week? So we'll just have to wait and see. Hopefully he'll be okay.
That card aside, there were certainly a number of yellows in that game. As far as friendlies go, there were a fair few late challenges going in.
It was competitive, and look, you're going to get that away from home in Europe. You know, you're going to get referees that make decisions that maybe don't suit your style of play or the British style of play. It's good to, you know, be reminded of that. I thought our discipline was good in the main. Jozo's been a bit rash. And maybe, you know, in a competitive game, that would be a red card, particularly in Europe. So we'll just have to accept that and move on.
9 times out of 10, Odson Edouard would have scored the penalty. It's the first clean sheet of the pre-season again. With another week's preparation before Sarajevo, you feel as if you're still on track?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, we had used half the squad today for the bounce game and then half the squad again today. Just to make sure they got enough minutes in the game, because some of them, if they'd have been all involved with the squad tonight, they'd have got maybe 15 minutes here, 20 minutes there, and that's not enough going into, you know, it's going to be an important week again. So we've used the, you know, two teams really today, and it was really, really, you know, you could see the fatigue kicking in towards the end of the game tonight, which is good, you know, and they've got up to, got the 90 minutes in the legs, which is important, and they will benefit from another week's training going into Sarajevo.
One player who didn't seem to lose any of that energy in his legs was Mikey Johnson, and he came so close at the start of that second half with a wonderful running shot.
Yeah, like I said, we had really good chances, you know, obviously the penalty, Mikey, Marion had a good chance first half, Johnny should have done better with a cutback for Mikey, so, you know, we could have maybe 2 or 3 tonight, but, and then Odson's clean through after Mikey, you know, he's just let it run away from him. So, you know, overall, you like to score goals, you know, but there's still obviously a bit of rust there, there's no question of that. But yeah, Mikey was excellent at times, and you know, he's really knocking on the door now for a regular place. I thought Scott Brown was superb tonight, reading of the game and just being in the right place at the right time when we needed him. I didn't like some of our players second half. I thought we were playing too much in front and in the second third of the pitch, and away from home in Europe, we need to play a little bit longer at times as well, and not invade pressure and just take the momentum away from the opposition.
Thanks, Neil.
Cheers, Jerry.